Hello YouTube, this is PSPHaCkErAOD, and I'm here to show you my new iPhone, which I just got. And it's pretty cool, but lots of flaws with this phone. First of all, when you get it out of the box, there we go. Alright, they already have a SIM card in it, and they want you pretty much to like register and whatever. They don't really tell you how to get the SIM card out, so you can put yours in, because they want you to register new phone number and plan and all that other junk. You stick a paper clip in there, you just push down until the tray pops up. It's like a little spring-loaded thing or something. Anyway, get rid of the paper clip, take out the SIM card, and take out the SIM for my blackjack. Okay. And put the SIM card back in the SIM tray. Slap that in. Alright, turn it on. Now, I've used this for a little bit, a couple days. And it's custom a little bit. Yeah, it'll stay. Takes forever to turn on. There it goes. Searching for signal, whatever. Okay. Now, first of all, it has a really, really good camera on this thing. They automatically save. Let's go back. Put a bunch of random pictures and things on there. But, yeah. It's pretty good. But, some pictures, let's see, cancel that. Go back to the camera roll. Some pictures, like, where's one I can use for an example? Some pictures you're gonna want to flip, like, some other way. It's gonna wanna, see, like, you turn it. Oh, nope. Now it looks normal. Nope. So, that's the flaw of that. Now, the internet on this thing, I'm impressed with, except for the fact that there's no G3 on it, so it's kind of slow. But, for the most part, it works out pretty well. One thing I like about this is, you have this keypad like this, and you turn it sideways, the browser page will turn. You can use a keypad like this. Now, this keypad, for some stupid reason, you can't turn it sideways and use it to text message like this. You have to use the other keypad to text message, which is like this, which is a lot harder to use. You think you'd be able to do both ways for the text messaging? No. Okay. Now, there is no video and no multimedia messages. There's applications out there you can install to do multimedia messaging. Doesn't work very well. Then to record video, there's also applications you can install in there. Where is it? This. It's not that good. Okay. Record whatever, and then it'll play it back, and that's all it'll do. It won't save or anything, so that's not very useful. And then the iPod part of the phone has many glitches as well. You know, ignore a lot of the stuff on here. It's a bunch of junk, but let's go to this. And it's not the music at all, the files, because I've used them on other stuff. But, here. Artists, first example. Where is it? Okay, first example will be Incubus. Turn the volume up. Okay. Artwork looks fine. Then you go to the next song. Huh, what happened to the artwork? Okay, so you turn the phone sideways, and there's still no artwork. Do this, and hey, you know what? The artwork's back. But then you click the CD, and it should have the artwork for both songs. See, Molly, there you click this one. You turn it back normal. Hey, there's the artwork. Next song, no. Turn it sideways. Hey, there's the artwork. It's gone. Okay. And then a lot of the songs, it has like trouble reading them, and it'll like glitch I know one song in particular it's really glitchy on. Which, album art view, because I don't know. There we go. Whoa. Okay. Now, it plays it normal at first. Yeah, tap that so you can see that also. Okay, right here it freaks out, but if you touch the thing, just move it a little bit, you can tell if the file's fine, it knows what it is, it just, for some reason it bugs up and it just decides to stop working. Just stupid. So, yeah, and if you let it sit when it does this, yeah, wait for it to stop playing again, and when it cuts out again, just let it sit, it's going to quit out of it. So, yeah, there it goes, it quit. Well, that's awesome. Alright. Yeah. And then, a lot of the applications, kind of stupid setup. I like it overall, but kind of bummed out. And then, one other thing I wanted to point out that's kind of stupid is you can use YouTube on this phone, but you close that off. If you go to YouTube on here and you look up a video, you won't be able to play it off the thing. You'll have to go to that other thing, which is kind of harder to find videos. Like, you can't type in like your account and get your computer favorites. You have to re-find all the videos and bookmark them, which is kind of a pain in the ass. And even though this is on Wi-Fi, it's still going slow. Oh, that's awesome. Can't display it today. Alright, well, guess I'm not going to bother showing that, but yeah, you can't like log in your account. It'll just like have some videos on here, whatnot. What am I? Yeah. There's no doing it this way or anything. Yeah. Very slow, I might add. Over the edge network, it's like almost impossible to do. It'll like take forever to load. I don't know why they didn't put G3 on this. Like, the Blackjack even has it. Okay, airplane video. Wow, that's even better. Okay, well, I guess today it's deciding to be a spaz. So, screw it. Alright, there was one more thing I forgot to show you. Also, that's another problem. It has a headphone jack there. That's nice and everything. Okay, these fancy little headphones it came with that don't sound that great. Yeah, crap, can't really do that well. There we go. Alright. Plugs in, okay. That's nice. It's like the perfect fit. Now, other headphones might not be exactly like that, and they won't plug into it exactly. So, like, say I want to plug into this stereo. I have this little thing here. I don't know if you can see it. This. And, yeah, doesn't fit. It goes in, but it's not all the way in, so it won't do anything. So then you have to use this stupid little stand that comes with. Plug that in, and then there's a plug on the back of that. You know, which is kind of a pain in the ass, because, you know, you have a headset that doesn't fit exactly. You're not going to have to carry this stupid stand around with you just so you can plug your freaking headphones into it, you know? So that's kind of a pain in the ass. And yeah, alright, another iPod problem.